So these recordings are a little bit out of sequence. I did not take any footage when I removed all these panels, so we're gonna try and explain things in reverse here, I suppose. So you've come here to see this video because your barn doors are stuck shut, you just can't open them. And so how did I get this open? Well, let me explain. Basically, you've got to loosen this piece off the loading sill, and remember, this will be actually stuck there. Now if you look down here, this that slides into that slot there. Now what you've got to realize is when that's stuck in there locked, there's no way you're going to be able to get this plastic piece off out of there, because it's essentially it's trapped in there. Let me show you. So that's going to be closing and then sliding into there, and that'll be on the underside, that'll be locked in there, so you won't be able to, you'll just simply imagine my, you know, I got my thumb through that little ring in there. You're not going to be able to pull that out until you get that lock mechanism disengaged, and then that'll just slip out. I'm going to show you what I did. Now first of all, I need to get this camera on a tripod because I need two hands for this. Give me a second. Okay, so here we are. Now imagine the door is stuck there, you just can't open it because the lock mechanism is faulty. So what you've got to do is loosen this panel off here. I'm not going to go through everything there, but it's you can sort of see what you need to do. Remove all the fasteners and that'll just sort of wiggle around like that while the door's closed, remember. And you could probably leave that lock you know, bolted in there and for this next step. But what you want is I've had this thing in my toolbox for many years, and man, it's been so handy over the years. It's about 2 inches that way, I don't know, 4 or 5 inches that way. I've put a point in there. Yeah, if you make up something like this, and I guarantee you're going to be using this through your lifetime, and that's what I use to pop the door open. So what you've got to do is it's not easy, but it's not impossible. Now I don't expect you to be able to get your head down in there and your eyes looking into there, so remember that sort of loose in there. You want to get your hand down and under there and into there. There's a cavity, there's a hole on the inside, and that hole especially there, so that you can get this in and out. And what you want to do, remember that's on the inside there. You basically what you've got to do, that's bolted in there, right under there, and basically get your little tool like this and blindly on that kind of an angle just sort of repeatedly do this against, you know, sort of a 45 degree, I suppose. Just repeatedly do that, and I guarantee in less than a minute you will hook what needs to be hooked. There's a latch there, and you'll just mechanically release this. And so I'm going to show you that now. Let's put this in the lock position, and basically you get this. Remember, you're not looking at it with your eyes, you're just feeling with your hand in there, and you're going like this. It's as simple as that. Done. again. You see that? Pretty easy. And when that happens, watch your face, because that door will just swing out and might smack you in the face. So yeah, that's all you do. And then you can remove these two screws in here and that'll just come out. Easy as that. Okay, so what we're going to do here is we're going to look at this connector for the locking mechanism for the right hand side door. This one here is for the left, which is goes near the bottom of the door. I want to look at the right hand mechanism and see if the connector is the same as this, and if it is, we'll do a bit of a swap and just see if the right mechanism can control this unit and vice versa. And so I need to determine whether this is faulty or whether the electrical system attempting to control this is faulty. At the moment it just twitches and this thing here is not disengaging. So let's get into that. Put down a bit of light coloured fabric so we can see the image a bit better. So what we got is this locking mechanism. It sort of goes something like this. Gets bolted up with these two points here. So it's a local BMW place here, and have told me that they're not prepared to order in a new one of these and allow me to plug it in. Just test it without paying for it, regardless if it works or not. So I'm not prepared to have that ordered and find that it still doesn't work, and I'm going to have to pay for that, and then I end up with a useless part. Well, it won't be useless, it'll just be a spare part hanging around for $245. Nah. So that's why what we're going to do is pull the mechanism out of here and see if it's got the same electrical connector as this one, and we'll plug it into here and see if the left door mechanism, this handle here, we'll see if it can control that mechanism there that we pull out of there. And and if it is the same, maybe we'll connect this one into the other door over there and see if the control for the right hand door can control this. So we want to determine if this is actually faulty or not. It does twitch when I activate the switch behind the handle here. It does a bit of a twitch and a click, but yeah, just not enough to disengage this. So let's get into that. I'm going to pull this out. What we've got here is a T30, I think. Yep, T30. Now, looking at this, so the one on my right hand here, it's come off the right door, and this one here has come off the left door. Printed on the plastic here, I don't know if you can see that there, we got the same numbering on this one. Now they actually look identical to me. Barcode on this one here is a bit washed out. Yeah, whether they electrically and mechanically they are the same on the inside, they certainly look identical on the outside. So that's a good thing. I'm going to take a bit of a risk. I'm going to try and plug this onto the left hand side, this one, and see what happens. The connector on the right door has a few more wires going into this connector here, so I don't know what's up with that, but let's give that a go. Okay, we've got the two front doors are closed, and the right hand suicide door, that is also closed. I've got the remote control in my hand here. Let's pull out. Now what I want to see is this locking mechanism disengage when I hit this button and hold it for a second or two. Let's see what happens. Now I don't know if you can hear that, it's just making a little sort of a sound, and it's not disengaging, which is exactly what it's doing when I plug it into the left hand side door. So remember, I've swapped these, so that to me is actually a good thing. Now coming across to this one, I'm going to try and pull this switch on the inside of this handle, and what I want to see is that locking mechanism down there disengage. Okay, now I can't do this and look at the camera at the same time. Oh, maybe I can. I'll just flip the screen around. Let's try and get the two of them in together. Right. Yeah. Let's see what we got here. Sweet. So I'm happy about that. What that means is the electronics to control the controller is actually able to provide enough juice to disengage a working module such as that. So I'm happy about that. So we can now conclude that without doubt that this unit here is actually faulty. So I could go back to the shop and order the $245 unit without fear of it not working, and I'll be all good to go. Which brings me to another idea, is maybe I'll try and open that and fix it old school. Since it's knackered anyway, you might have a bit of a look-see inside and see what makes it tick, and maybe it's actually repairable. So yeah, that's a good result for me. Let's pull all that off because I need to use the car, and got a bit of a plan here. Now we're going to try and pull one of those units apart and try and repair it. Failing that, we'll just order a new one. with confidence, so sweet. Let's see how it's looking on the inside right now. There you go. Probably taken off more than I needed to, but you know, the very first time you just don't know these things. I had no issue pulling it all apart. At least this will buy me some time to either order a new part, or that part's probably going to take a few days to arrive. Whether I get it from our local BMW dealer or somewhere, or whether I order it from overseas from the likes of eBay or wherever, I don't know yet. But either way, while it's, if it is ordered, then I can then rip apart the other one and see what I can do about it. Cool. Okay, another day here. Ideally I'd have this camera on a tripod, etc., but got a bit of wind noise on the other side of the house, so I've come to this side and we're just gonna try and go steady cam style. So this is the locking mechanism, left barn door. If we were to stand at the rear of the vehicle looking in, this would go just under the loading sill and bolted this orientation here. So we know this is faulty. Because it's faulty, I thought, well, why not try and open it and see what we can do about it before we actually go ahead and order a new one, which is going to cost me $245 New Zealand dollars. Now I've been to a wrecker, specialised in European and BMW vehicles. They had one unit there and that is also faulty, and after driving around the city yesterday I wasn't unable to successfully find another unit to try, so here we are. I'm going to attempt to pull this open now. This is a metal plate here and most of this side is plastic, so what I'm going to do is let me try and, this metal plate here has all these little wings that are bent in to hold it against the plastic molding. So there's one there, you see that, there's one there, it's folded in. I'm looking through a viewfinder, so of the camera is sort of not easy to look at it. There's one there, there's one there. Anyway, there's a few of them all around, so we've got to bend these tabs out. And the plan is to lift this plate off, probably going to hold it in that orientation when I lift it off. Now the other complication is these things here, these things, if I look very very closely, come on focus, are we focusing or was my viewfinder not focused? Let's open this screen. Uh,
Yeah, sorry, if I look closely at these, they appear to be flared over and sort of little lines around the edge indicating that it's been in some kind of a press machine and pressed, so to get those out I'm probably going to need to get an angle grinder and grind those off. Now how am I going to get that back together? Well, I'm hoping we can just go back to a good old humble nut and bolt instead of this system here. I don't know, we're going to have to see and make a decision there. Either way, that's the plan. I'll bend these off camera and I'll probably grind these on this side off camera. As I say, we've got a lot of wind noise on the other side of the house here today, so rather than annoy you with all that wind noise, I'll do that off camera. Okay, see you in the next bit.
Okay, so here it is. Ground all these off, bent back these wings, and separated this off here. Now, in hindsight, this one here, I would probably leave this one. If I had to open one of these in the future, don't grind this. Grind that and that one and bend the wings and just sort of gently pry it off, but take a lot of care because it's very easy to crack this plastic as you're trying to lift this off. But yeah, this is the important one. Don't take this one off. So that comes off, and what you've got here is this here needs to be sprung loaded, so you see that it's sprung loaded, and this one here is sprung loaded. Now it's sort of I'm just trying to hold it together here. That's sprung loaded in, and this is sprung loaded this way, there and there. And when this wheel spins, it's got these little wings here, and as it spins, it looks like it spins this way clockwise, which then swipes on this little black thing sticking up, does a bit of a swipe on there and pushes that down as it turns, and which then does that. Now, I've just dropped it. So the problem I've found in here is this sprocket. There's the, it's a little motor there, that's a little auger type situation there. And this engages down into that auger. There's a spiral teeth there. I don't know if that's a technical term for it, but anyway, that goes down to there. But the problem with this is it's cracked. Here's the other piece here. Now, I'm not going to, I've decided the amount of work and whatnot, I'm not going to glue that at all. I could glue it and put a bag and whatnot, but yeah, I've decided I'm just going to get a new one. So I'm going to go online, might get one from overseas. Yeah, I'll keep you posted. Yeah, there's no need to grind this one because it holds the sprocket and that would actually come away with this piece. So, yeah. Something exciting arrived today, and it's our new part for the barn door, left barn door, and I'm quite keen to check it out, and I pray that I've ordered the right part. Let's find out. Okay, so far. Don't want to destroy those stickers, so let's go through the put the bag. Looks good. Our locking mechanism has arrived today, and it's taken probably, I don't know, 6 weeks or something. So this is a new one that's come in the regular mail today. I thought customs might have contacted me and asked for some, I don't know, taxes or something, but no, that wasn't the case, so I'm happy about that. This is the faulty unit here, which belongs to the left barn door, and this is the good unit that came off the right barn door. Now I'm thinking whether it's left or right door, I think these are interchangeable. The barn door on the right seems to be a two or more extra cables that plug into this connector here. Not 100% sure what those extra wires are for, but I suspect it gives a signal back to the car computer or something to let the car know that the barn doors are actually locked properly. So I think that's what that is. Now this one being the right barn door, the last two digits on this barcode is 5. Now the left barn door, you can't see it well, but it is there. The last two digits on this barcode is 06. And the new unit that's come in today also has 06, so this matches the faulty barcode, and the number on the plastic here also matches the faulty unit, so that should be a direct replacement. I probably will do some tests and swap left and right in the car and see if everything functions all right, because Even though those two digits are different, it would be nice to know if they actually still are interchangeable. Who knows what the two end numbers mean? They could be, you know, maybe it was manufactured at a later time or in a different factory or something. Don't know. But my guess is they're interchangeable. And if they are, you know, it's good to know for the future. I can just order either or. Since looking at a lot of the online stores, they will actually specify left and right when you're buying them, and you know, you might want a left and that's not available, but they're selling one for the right. And yeah, time will tell. We might be able to buy a right for the left, regardless of what the online stores are telling us. So I'll figure that out. We're not going to do that today because we're kind of running out of light. I've got the car running here, and what I'm trying to do is wait for the symbol showing the barn doors in the rear open, but they never come on immediately anyway. So, and you know, I don't want to take the car out on the road right now. But normally there'd be an icon there showing the barn doors open at the back, if it's not locked properly, and I don't even have the locks hooked up at the back. So, but what we can do, what I have noticed is when the barn doors are not locked at the back, then it's pretty, as far as I can tell, it's impossible to operate the rear window washer and also the rear wipers. So the fact that I can't do that is telling me that it's not, the car is not sensing that the doors are locked, which is actually what I expect. So rather than rely on the barn door icon here, I'm going to rely on this. And what I'm wanting to do is do a test and swap left and right lock mechanisms with the doors so that we can determine if they are interchangeable or not. So that's going to be my test. Well, that's the front wiper, so these are not operating anything in the back windows, and so that's all good. Now I'm going to go and hook up the good locks and see what sort of outcome we get. Okay, so we got the left lock connected to the left door and the right lock connected to the right door, and I've put the lock mechanism into the lock position. They're just hanging there at the moment, and let's see if we can get some action on the rear wipers. We do, so that's good. So it's, yeah, so I think that confirms for me that the extra wires that are going into the mechanism for the right door at the rear send some signal to the car to tell the car that it's actually locked, and when it is locked we can then operate the wipers and the window washer, etc. So great, now I'm going to go back and swap the locks over. Remember the two digits on the barcode sticker, they are different, the two last digits on the end are different. When I say the end, I mean the right, the end on the right side of the barcode. So I'll go back there, swap those, and we'll be back. Okay, the lock for the left barn door is now connected to the car for the right barn door, and the one on the right is now connected to the left, and the two locks are again in the lock position. And what I want to see is if I can operate the wipers and the window washer, etc., and I can. So that to me tells me that left and right lock mechanisms are totally, well, I'm going to add a disclaimer here. From what I can make out, totally interchangeable. But that's, yeah, that's the way I see it. Don't take my word for it, but that's the way I'm seeing it right now. The car's running right now. I'm going to jump out and actually... Well, actually, no, I've got to turn the car off so I can get the key out, so I can push the button to unlock the lock mechanism. So let's do that. Right, we're at the door on the right. This here originally, well, this is the new unit which the intention is to put this on the left, but I don't think it really matters. Anyway, we're going to hit this button. What we want to see is that lock thing disengaged, which it does. So that's the new one, and that functions just fine. And this one here, the same. This originally was on the right door. So the door here has a switch behind the handle, and what we're going to do is simulate us opening first the right door, then the left, because that's the order, and that's the only order that the doors can be opened. So we've already opened that one. And this one here, can we get them both in the shot? Let's try and move that over a bit. Okay. It's not easy. Anyway, here we go. I'm going to hit the button on 1, 2. Great. Yeah. Totally interchangeable. So that's good news. In the future I'll just buy left or right. Yeah, some of the shops are not available left or right, and some of them the left is more expensive than the right, but as you can see in my test, it really doesn't matter. So now it's time to get this thing back together. Okay, so I've just been down to Super Cheap Auto to buy a couple of spare, well not spare, to buy a couple of bulbs for the bottom of the barn doors. One goes left, one goes right. Now, some people online are calling these puddle lights. So the lights shine down onto the ground and you can see, don't step into puddles, you know. Now, just as the guy was going to look in the computer to see what's available for this car, I said, I have the old ones here, and pretty much without looking, he said, oh, I know what those are. They are this and that and whatever else. And yeah, I'm a little bit doubtful to what this, the true specifications are, because I know if the wattage is too high, they'll get too hot, and these things can melt, you know, and I don't want that. But he's given me 12 volt, 3 watts, without actually searching on his computer, so he better be right, otherwise I'm going to be a bit upset. So let's open those up and see what they do. Now, we can actually open the door from here now, which is great. Cool. Parts from the faulty unit in here, so I'll keep all that. You never know what I'll need in the future.